Hey everybody, thanks for watching this week. I want to talk to you a little bit about what's going on with Afghanistan because it's just stolen my heart this week, especially when I just found out about the canine dogs that were left behind there as well. I don't know if you realize, but this is a persecution of Christians here. If you really understand what is going on in Afghanistan, you will know that for 20 years, this was a society that was built, that was being built up there. You had churches, you had people, you had missions that were there to bring the people back to a civilized type of society. And of course, for 20 years, there was progress that was made there. This is why they decided to start getting out of the country, because these things were happening there. They had had a president there, they had military, they had all of this stuff there. You know, whatever happened because the administration that we have at the moment, not even an administration, what we have right now is pretty much a regime, a communist, a tyrannical regime. These people were there, these missions were there to bring back this society to a civil type of law. And they were showing people the Bible. They were reading, and they were reading the Bible to these people. These people were turning to Christ. And they had churches there. And a lot of the people that got stuck there, they were actually people that were in missions. You know, I don't know about you, but if you're traveling to another country and with American passport, you would think that your embassy, that your country would stand by you, right? So, I mean, think of it this way. Right now, a lot of you, if you plan on traveling out of the U.S., you have just seen what this regime is doing, to the point that if you plan on traveling, you're on your own. You can't expect that the embassy, if you walk into an embassy, if there's a problem in whatever country you're at, you're going to have any results, because as you've seen, lots of thousands of people were left behind. And it's just appalling the things that we've seen right now. A real leader would never, never leave his troops behind the way that this regime has done in the last week. This regime has prioritized three things here. He prioritized the Taliban first. He prioritized the vehicles. He also prioritized the fighting men and got them out before women and children. This is the level that we are seeing right now. He left Americans in a waiting list, and they're not out and they're not getting out. So I'm sure that by 9/11, we're going to start seeing on video some of the most disgusting, hateful things that you will ever see in your life. And this is a war against Christians. This is exactly what they're trying to show you. They're trying to keep you from going to Christ, because now you're going to be afraid to wear a cross. You're going to be afraid to wear a t-shirt with a cross, because you walk in the street now with these people, these crazies walking around, and you're not sure if they're going to do something to you in this country. We shouldn't live in a country where we're not able to wear whatever we want because of fear that somebody's going to blow up a bomb or something in the store that we're at, or take out a weapon and shoot us, right? That's the level that we're at this point with all of these people that are coming into here. And I don't have a problem with taking in immigrants. I have a problem when you're not checking to see who those people are and what they stand for. And this happened in the chaos. And this is what happens in the devil's domain. It's always order out of chaos. And that's exactly what you're seeing here with this regime. Another thing I want to talk about in this video as well is there are things that are happening behind the scenes. And I'm one of those that I go looking. I'm like looking for this, looking for that. Like, okay. So we all know that the regime has not really been in the White House. Like, he doesn't sleep in the White House. And the other one, she doesn't sleep in the vice presidential house. And we know when he tried to get into the Pentagon, they wouldn't allow him in. So I don't know what's happening, but I know there's something internal within the government that's happening. And this could be retribution for that, because there could be a division between our military inside. And this is what's going on. And I think this is actually what's happening. But I'm a little bit angry at some of the people that are out there, like Dan, like Bongino and some other people. They don't talk about this stuff. They don't talk about the fact that he's not in the White House. Why don't they let him in the house? Why don't these people, these Republicans, talk about this stuff so that we can kind of understand what's going on? Why do they keep it like nobody talks about this stuff? We know that it's happening, right? We know that the gates are up for a long time in the White House. And a lot of people say that he's not even filming from there. We have people, if you go online looking on YouTube, where he has said that he was filming from there, and people are standing there and they're saying, no, he's not. I'm filming from here and there's nothing going on over there. So why aren't these things being talked about even in the media or from the people who are supposed to be talking about this kind of stuff and these inconsistencies with this so-called election that he was chosen? For me, it's very obvious. You know, this is still up in the air and they're still trying to find out who the winner is. And of course, you know, these people are attacking it every step that they can. And a lot of the stuff they're doing as distractions against those things, so they're not found out. So this guy now, this regime, do you really want to trust him with the pandemic that's going on right now? I mean, this is a guy who screwed up big time with the F, right? He also gave the Russians the pipeline. He is causing major inflation in our country. He also has a border crisis going on in this country. The gas prices are already hitting $3 and going way up. And in some places, they're $4 and $5. And of course, the fraud that was perpetrated on us and in certain states, right? So how can we trust these people with this pandemic stuff when we can't trust him for this stuff? I mean, he also canceled the pipeline here in the U.S. that was helping lots of people during a difficult time to work. So the timing was bad there as well. He doesn't talk to the reporters. So when you want to ask him a question, because if I was there, I'd ask him, well, why aren't you sleeping in the White House? Well, you know, I would ask him so many questions. Why don't we have people there who ask the questions that we want to know? This is the problem that we're having that pisses me off. And it's making me, I don't know if you guys are pissed off about it too, but I'm looking at this and I'm getting pissed off about this stuff. And you're going to see when 9/11 comes around, September 11, you're going to see the things that you're going to watch on the news. And that's exactly around the time frame about the so-called Maricopa County votes are going to be in. So we'll see if they don't try to delay that or not, because from my understanding, that's going to be another 30 days. So I'm not sure if that's even going to happen. But you'll see they'll try to distract us with hangings and people hanging from helicopters and dogs getting eaten and little kids getting burned alive, Christians, especially missionaries that were left there. I mean, this stuff that I'm telling you, this is pure evil, pure evil. You know, if you don't think that this was planned, this whole thing about leaving all of these weapons behind and all of this stuff, if you don't think that this was planned that way and it was intentional, then you are super, super, super naive. I would blow my mind that if you tell me right now that you were that. Because it's very obvious that we have the enemy within and they're fighting against us. And he's trying to lead others to fight against us, right? That's exactly what we learn about in the Constitution.
Mr. Biden, you did this. You made the deal with the Taliban. This is the consequences of it.
The enemy is within. And that is exactly where we're at. So we are waiting to find out what our military is planning on doing. And that's what I'm waiting on. I know that we have some people in the military that we have to remove because they're not trustful.
Dozens and dozens of U.S. citizens went to the airport and the gates never opened.
This regime, what they're doing is actually supplying the terrorists with weapons against us. This is what they're doing. This is exactly, and not only the weapons, but now they're bringing in the army in here as well, because you will see that coming up where they're going to start doing things like that. Because guess what? If you looked at some of the videos that are out there, you know, the Pride Boys have pretty much destroyed Antifa and BLM. And that's pretty much something that's going away. And I believe that there's so many black people in America who have woken up to the truth about the lies, how they're always using racial this and racial that. This is why they're bringing in these Afghan people, because some of them are dark skinned. They're going to try to do the racial divide thing here as
well. Black Lives Matter is our campaign.
Basically, you are the new black people of America. If we don't stand, you will see Muslims murdered in the streets. We are the community that staged a revolution across the world. If we could do that, why can't we have that revolution in America?
Look, I don't have a problem with them as long as they're good people and they're decent people. But when they're coming here planning to be suicide bombers or shoot people, that I have a problem with. And it's our government, the one that we can't trust, to let us know if these people should be here or not, or to send them back. Oh, not only this, so now this regime is also attacking our good military by threatening them that if they don't get the jab, they're going to ruin their pension, their tuition assistance, they're going to not get the GI Bill. If they refuse to take it, this is pretty much medical tyranny is what's happening in this country right now. They're trying to control everything, especially with these guys. And these people are totally against us. So I'm interested to know what you think about all of this as well, because I give him an F big time. I mean, he needs to leave, and the other one that's there as well. And if we finally need to get a president back who respects this country, who works for the people of this country, and doesn't put us in harm's way. And then we also need to go back and get those citizens that were left behind in Afghanistan. So especially those people who are doing the missions, and their priests pray for these people, because these people, it is not good to think of what's going to happen to these people. And this list, that supposedly this kill list, is going to probably expose a lot of those people on that list. So it's really upsetting for me to see a lot of this Taliban and this people walking around in soldiers' uniforms, looking like American soldiers, riding around in product and equipment that the Americans that the Americans paid with tax dollars here. And I'm really upset about all of this. So I'm interested to know what you think. And please leave it in the comments. And I continue to pray for the people in Afghanistan and for the families here who lost their loved ones, or the ones that are waiting, that are still waiting for loved ones who didn't make it on a plane, who are still over there and they can't contact them. They have no way of knowing if they're alive or dead or what's happening to them. So we also need to pray for those people as well, as we also need to pray for our politicians to do the right thing and to get this administration out. And let's get somebody in there who is going to be able to do the job the way the American people want it. And I also will have a link for you down below. Please make your voices heard. You have a way to do so. There's some links in the description box where you can actually connect to the White House. There's a phone number there where you can call and leave a voicemail and let them know what you think. Let them know. Let's get those phones going and telling them what we think. We don't know if they're going to do it, if they're going to listen to us, but you know what? We should be complaining and telling them all the time what's going on. There's also going to be connections and links down below for you to be able to call your representative or email them and let them know that you are disappointed in what's going on. We have to put pressure. We have to do it, even if it's sitting from our homes and we're not out there lifting banners and stuff like that. We really, really, really have to be calling and doing our due diligence of calling our representatives to let them know that we're not happy. Even if people online are telling you, oh, it doesn't really matter, they don't listen to you. You know, if you vote for one, you vote for the same thing, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. We still have to do our part, because we are Christian, we're a Christian-based nation, and that is our duty, is to do the right thing. And we have to bring this nation back to God, and that's part of it, doing our job to bring it back to God. So I thank you for watching today. I hope that you will go down to the description box and make your voice heard to those people who we hope will start turning this situation around. I hope you have a blessed day. I'll see you back next week. Bye-bye.